the present situation that we see, or the war of words that we are seeing play out, has got to do with domestic politics, with international politics, with geopolitics, muscle flexing, the Americans, the Quad, and things like that, and the internal political dynamic of China. But when President Xi says that he believes that the reunification will happen between China and mainland China and Taiwan, is it just a message to his domestic audience and also to the international audience, or does he mean that? Does China at any stage want to unite Taiwan with itself? Would it go to that length?
The usual expression that the Chinese have successively used for about last 20 years, since the anti-succession law was passed in 2004, which is the time when first democratic elections happened in Taiwan, which is what Beijing quite did not approve of, the language is that China will use non-peaceful means. So they're not saying openly military means, but apparently that implies. And now a lot of people are talking of, yes, the usual language Chinese have used, starting from their anti-succession law of 2004, when first democratic elections happened in Taiwan, which Beijing did not approve of, is to say non-peaceful means will be used. But in current context, I think it's interesting to see how next year is a very crucial year for President Xi Jinping, when his second tenure ends as party secretary. And to move to third tenure is going to be very unusual compared to the conventions set in China so far. So, you know, it could be seen domestically to kind of create such a tense situation where Xi Jinping is seen as the savior, and unusual situation leads to him being allowed the third term. At international level, again, if China has to constantly showcase its power, and there is an old Chinese saying that, you know, kill a rooster to scare the monkey. Mm-hmm. That again is an example. If China has to browbeat in terms of force projection any neighbor, Taiwan would perhaps be the easiest neighbor. And the strategy they are using.
My question, Professor, is, I agree, I understand that point, that it may be muscle flexing in the international arena, coupled with playing to the domestic gallery for President Xi. Will the Chinese state go to the extent of annexing Taiwan? What is your assessment? Or is it just a war of words?
Let me say that it is very important to understand how Chinese are outlining their strategy of such an annexation. And China is already the largest trading partner for Taiwan, about $100 billion. Bigger mm-hmm. trade than India has with China. Taiwanese have invested about $60 billion into China. About 1 million Taiwanese live in China. So Chinese are not going to kind of invade militarily and sort of annex Taiwan the way most people must be assuming things to happen. But it's gradually going to stress out, fatigue Taiwan, and present itself as a bully and a powerful example where, you know, they would see, it's like, you know, hostage syndrome story, where Taiwanese would gradually begin to realize that perhaps it is better for them to work with China. And sort of very often when the nationalist party lead, Kuomintang party, comes to power, they have much better relations with Beijing. It's only when DPP comes to power that this whole strand of Taiwan being independent, etc., comes up. Force projections that you saw today in National Day becomes important. But otherwise, I think there is an enormous amount of, if you want to use the word annexation or assimilation, you know, these are semantics. But to large extent, there is already that sort of assimilation that has happened. What is important for China is to show its power. And that's a signal to all other neighboring countries of China. And that is where this constant, sorties of jets going over the air defense system of Taiwan, and Taiwanese outcry, which is not being responded globally at all. Nobody gives takes care of Taiwan anymore. So no country is going to come to rescue of Taiwan is being demonstrated by Xi Jinping that, you know, there is no country which is going to stand up and, you know, speak for you and defend you in case of trouble. And mm-hmm. that sends a message to other countries. ASEAN would be the immediate next set of countries to okay. get the message.
All right.
Maybe others as well. So it's a kind of a multidimensional strategy where it's a peeling of onions kind of a story where China is very gradually, imperceptibly assimilating Taiwan. Mm-hmm. And it's not going to be triggering a war because that could be extremely mm-hmm. costly and that could trigger international responses. Okay. Chinese are not foolish. They're not going to do that.
Okay. I'm totally out of time, Professor Swaran Singh. I'll ask you the last question, and if you could please briefly answer me that. From an Indian point of view, even as today, you know, these developments were taking place at Moldo along the LAC, we were talking to the Chinese holding a 13th commander level talks to resolve the build-up at the LAC. Is there a message for India? Should India... how much of concern should India be, should have about these developments in the region?
I think there is a direct impact that it has. China being emboldened vis-a-vis any other neighbor will have a direct impact on all the neighbors, including India. And we can see this reticent approach that we are noticing in 13 rounds of talks, and nothing moves on the ground in that sense. And in that sense, I think also the more unstable that the region becomes, that again is something which is clearly negative, will put greater stress on Quad, and that India is part of Quad, will be expected to sort of say something. My assumption from what has happened in history so far is that when the tension had really increased in 1995, when the first leader was elected from Kuomintang, the way promises were made by Clinton administration and the way fleets on the ground were moving in oceans, fleets were expected to come to the Taiwan Straits, and they were 4 days behind. So United States at best will be happy to give them weaponize, sell them arms to Taiwan, which again makes Beijing very angry. I don't see any possibility of any country today willing to stand up. Only 14 small countries are recognizing, and even they one by one will give up. And if there is no country recognizing the Taiwan, then okay. Taiwanese will understand what are the choices left to them. So you can notice if there is no international response, United Nations is not bothered about it, or any
okay.
Quad nations or grouping is not bothered about it. It's a message mm-hmm. for China that they can continue doing what they want, and that has an impact on India as well.
All right. Ambassador Anil Wadhwa, Professor Swaran Singh, both thank you very much for joining on the show and sharing your insights with us this evening. Thank you.